Hello everyone. Today we're going to take a look at the Hunter HawkEye XL alignment system. This HD aligner features brand new camera and target technology that is unparalleled to previous Hunter HD alignment systems. This system provides a wide variety of coverage for multiple styles of vehicles, and this system can be used in any bay, at any height, on the floor, or a lift rack. We'll show you how to position a vehicle for a roll forward compensation. Then we'll talk about selecting the proper vehicle configuration and alignment specifications for the vehicle we're working on. Then we'll show you how to mount our adapters and targets to the vehicle so they're securely fastened. And finally, we'll talk about some of the alignment software features that make your job as a technician more efficient and more productive. Let's take a look. So to start the alignment process, we'll pull our vehicle into our alignment bay. With the help of our spotter, we'll position the vehicle for a roll forward compensation. So now that we've pulled our truck into our bay, one of the first things we need to do is make sure that our turn plates are positioned correctly for doing our roll forward compensation. So let's take a look at our turn plates. We'll make sure it's centered on the tire and wheel. So we'll look at our center portion of the turn plate here and our center portion of the ribs of our tire, and make sure that it's positioned correctly. So now that our truck and turn plates are correctly positioned, we need to position our forward wheel chock. We'll grab our wheel chock and our indicator, place our indicator there underneath the leading edge of the tire. We'll pull our wheel chock till our string is slightly tight. And that helps position our wheel chock in the perfect spot for our roll forward compensation. The next thing we need to do is select our vehicle configuration and alignment specifications. Let's take a look at our software. So to start, we'll click Begin Alignment, and this will take us to our vehicle configuration screen. Today we're working on a 3-axle truck with a front steer axle and 2 drive axles as shown here on the screen. And we're going to use our last rear axle as our reference axle for the alignment. Next, we need to select the correct alignment specification for the vehicle that we're working on. So we'll hit space bar on our spec menu here. Jump down to heavy duty vehicles. Today we're working on a Volvo, so we'll type in Volvo, bring us down to that selection, and we're working on the VN series truck today. Now the next thing we need to do is identify our front axle on this truck. For today, this is a Hendrickson axle underneath this Volvo. So now that we're on our specification screen, you might notice up at the top it's asking us to enter a reference diameter. That reference diameter is the overall assembly diameter of the front tire and wheel on this particular truck. For today, this measures 39 inches. So we'll enter 39, we'll press enter, and you'll see a total toe specification number appear towards the bottom of the screen. So now that we've selected our specification for our vehicle that we're working on, let's go to the next step and look at mounting our sensors. So here on this screen, one of the first things I want to point out is our plan view over on the right-hand side. This is a key to the multi-axle alignment process. The plan view is a visual graphic that guides you through the alignment procedure based on the configuration that we selected earlier. In this case, a 3-axle truck. The graphic should match what we are aligning, which in this case, it does. But if not, then we should update our selection before moving to the next step. So now that we've followed our on-screen instructions, let's talk about our 2 compensation methods. Number 1 is quick comp. That's going to be our roll forward, fast and easy method of compensating our targets. Our other option is jacking compensation, which is going to take a little bit more time, but is available for trucks with certain configurations that require the axles to be jacked up to compensate our targets. So for this demonstration, we'll select our quick comp procedure. So let's talk about mounting our targets. One of the first things we'll do is place our spades here at the top of the wheel. And then first, we'll adjust our diameter to match our rim diameter. And then make sure our bottoms are secured as well. And we'll tighten down our knob at the top to secure the adapter to the wheel. The last step is to make sure that our arrow here is roughly pointed straight up and down. So we'll unlock our cam lever here. And then we'll rotate our target just slightly to make sure that that arrow is pointed straight up. And then we'll relock our cam. So now that we've mounted our first target and adapter, let's repeat the process for our other 5. You'll notice there are no electronics, no batteries, and no wireless communication involved with our new target technology. For the rearmost axle, we'll use the shaft extensions so the targets are visible for the cameras up at the aligner cabinet. So now that we have all of our targets and adapters mounted to the truck, let's go ahead and roll comp so we can get some alignment readings. So we're going to use Hunter's optional truck pusher here, and we're going to push from the rear tire on this truck. And when we do that, we want to make sure we don't block the targets as we're rolling forward. Let's go ahead and roll. At the end of our roll, we want the center of the tires to be positioned at the center of the turn plates. So we'll go ahead and roll forward till our bar graphs on the aligner turn green. And once they turn green, the aligner is going to automatically unlock the turn plates and slip plates for us. So now that we've compensated our targets, let's go ahead and measure caster. So for caster, obviously we'll be up in the truck behind the steering wheel here, and we'll follow our prompts on the screen. So we'll go ahead and steer left till our bar graphs turn green, and we'll steer back right. Do the same thing till our bar graphs turn green. And then we'll turn back straight, once again, till our bar graph turns green. So now that we've measured caster, let's take a look at our software again. So over here on the right side is actually what we refer to as our procedure bar. This is basically our custom built alignment based on the truck and configuration that we selected at the beginning of our alignment. Now, if you notice, the software has actually already prompted us to come in adjust thrust angle on the rear axle. This is another feature of our WinAlign software that basically guides the technician through the alignment process using our K keys down at the bottom. Specifically, that green one down on the right-hand side we refer to as K4. That's accompanied by our other soft keys, starting on the left-hand side, K1, then K2, K3, and then again K4 being OK in the green button all the way on the right. So now that we've discussed our procedure bar, there's one other feature I want to point out. So up here above our procedure bar, you'll see a blue question mark with a video camera. This is our Align Guide training and information button. If we click on this, we have a suite of different videos that highlight some of the different adjustments we might see on this Volvo truck, as well as a full table of contents for the operation manual for this software. So we can use this as a quick, handy reference guide for any questions that might come up while we're using our software. Let me show you how the procedure bar actually walks us through the alignment process. So over on the right-hand side, we have our plan view that we talked about earlier. The axle that we're currently working on is the rearmost axle on this truck, as indicated by the wrench icon. Now, once we've made our adjustments on the rear axle, we can click K4. The software will show us our measurements on the rear axle for camber and toe. Clicking K4 again will then take us to the middle axle, again as indicated here on our plan view with the wrench icon, and this will allow us to adjust our scrub angle on that middle axle of our Volvo tractor. Once the middle axle has been adjusted, the process will continue with the front axle to adjust front caster and front toe. After making adjustments on the front axle, we'll continue the process to generate our printout. As you can see on our printout screen, we have many different styles of printouts you can use to document your work now that the alignment has been completed. So now that we've discussed aligning our Volvo here with three axles, let's talk about vehicles with four or more axles. So to align a four-axle vehicle, we'll begin our alignment. And from our configuration screen, we'll select our one front, three rear truck tractor configuration. We'll click OK. We'll select our rear axle as our reference axle. We'll follow the steps to identify the correct specification for our vehicle. So we'll go through and select our Volvo truck tractor with our Hendrickson axle. So now that we've selected the correct specification for the vehicle that we're working on, we'll use our quick comp procedure to take our initial alignment readings. So if we look at our plan view over here on the right side, you'll notice that we actually have a truck selected that has four axles, a front steer and three drive axles. And our wrench icon is indicating that we're actually working on our rearmost axle. Now, one of the unique features of the Hunter HawkEye XL system is we can actually measure three axles simultaneously with our targets. Now, on a four-axle truck like this, we'll actually have to move a set of targets throughout the alignment procedure so we can measure all four of these axles. So as we go through the alignment process, as you can see, we're working on the rear axle here as indicated by our wrench icon. Once we've aligned our thrust angle on that rearmost axle, we can advance to the next axle. Now we've moved up to our middle axle here. Again, as indicated by our wrench icon on our plan view, we can adjust our scrub angle to zero. Once we've done that, we can advance to the next axle. In this case, WinAlign is actually going to prompt us to go to the front axle to adjust caster and toe as needed. So now that we've successfully adjusted caster and toe on our vehicle here, WinAlign actually is going to prompt us to move a set of targets to our forward middle axle so we can get accurate measurements and make adjustments on that axle. Now, one big benefit of this is we'll actually be able to use our quick comp roll forward compensation to compensate that set of targets on that axle. Let's talk about one last configuration, twin steer vehicles. Twin steer vehicles typically have a tandem twin steer axle on the front end of the vehicle to allow for increased mobility. Our software can actually handle aligning those vehicles. Let's take a look. So we'll jump in and click Begin Alignment. And from our configuration screen, we'll scroll down to a two front, two rear truck tractor. And you'll notice our plan view over here on the right-hand side actually shows a twin steer front end. So we've got our tandem steer axles on the front end of this vehicle and our tandem drive axles on the rear. So selecting this configuration will actually prompt the aligner to build out a custom alignment process for us over here on our procedure bar. So as you can see with this twin steer configuration and the multitude of other configurations that we have on our list here, Hunter HawkEye XL is equipped to handle a plethora of different vehicles that you may see in your shop. So that's the Hunter HawkEye XL alignment system. For training information, more product details, or to connect with your local Hunter team, visit us at our website, hunter.com. Thanks for watching.